I wanted to point to some other artists who spoke out against war. E.E. Cummings. I sing of Olaf, glad and big, whose warmest heart recoiled at war, a conscientious objector. But though all kinds of officers, a yearning nation's blue-eyed pride, their passive prey did kick and curse, until for wear their clarion voices and boots were much the worse, and egged the first-class privates on his rectum wickedly to tease by means of skillfully applied bayonets, roasted hot with heat, Olaf, upon what were once knees, does almost ceaselessly repeat, there is some shit I will not eat. And Eugene O'Neill, the great playwright, and this was 6 months after Pearl Harbor. This is important because, E. Cummings was reacting to World War I, and other writers were reacting to World War I, that great martial spirit that was summoned up in 1917 when they were getting the United States into war, and when they were marshaling people into line, and the flag was being waved, and then the war was over, and people looked at the 10 million dead on the battlefields of Europe and asked, what was this all about? And then the disillusionment began to arise. And people began to think again. Because after that first wave of flag waving and bugles blowing and let's this, we gotta do this, and look at the terrible things they did, and look at the, and yes, and terrible things were being done. And so therefore, we have to do terrible things. That's war. War is terrible things done on one side, and terrible things done on the other side. And then, after a while, the second thoughts come, there are all these people dead, and what did we accomplish? What have we done? And that's what happened after World War I. That's what led to the writings of John Dos Passos and Ernest Hemingway and Ford Madox Ford, and that great novel, that great anti-war novel by Dalton Trumbo, Johnny Got His Gun, which I recommend to all of you. You can read it in one evening, and you won't forget it. But it's good to remember that, even when the war is presumably a good war, because wars always look good at the beginning. They always look good at the beginning to a lot of people, because this rush of fervor based on something terrible that has been done and something that must be done in retaliation. And then only later does the thinking begin and the questioning begin.